Everyone knows the moon orbits the Earth. But what if I told you that's only half the truth? Because in reality, the Earth orbits the moon too. Okay, not quite like that, but close. The Earth and the moon form a celestial system. They spin around a point in between them. That point is the barycenter, the balance point of their masses. That barycenter is not at the center of the Earth. It's actually about 4,671 kilometers from Earth's center, or roughly 1,700 kilometers beneath our feet, somewhere in Earth's mantle, closer to the moon side. That is why Earth does a kind of cosmic shimmy, a subtle wobble as it traces little loops in space. So what does this mean for us? This tiny wobble actually affects a bunch of stuff. We know the sun and the moon pulls on Earth's oceans, creating tides. But here's the twist. The entire Earth is being pulled too. Because Earth itself orbits the barycenter, it experiences a pseudo-centrifugal force, slightly flinging the oceans on the far side of the moon outward. Whoa. That's why we get two tidal bulges, one facing the moon and one facing away. So yes, your beach vacation is secretly choreographed by Earth's off-center waltz. For the high-precision stuff, like GPS, intercontinental missiles, or deep space probes, has to account for Earth's micro-movement. One wrong assumption and... whoops! Your Mars lander is now a Martian pancake. What's exciting is that barycenters can help us discover alien worlds. When we look at distant stars, we often can't see their planets directly, but we can detect a star's tiny wobble as it orbits its own barycenter with an unseen planet. This method, called the radial velocity method, has helped discover hundreds of exoplanets. You know the moon is slowly leaving us. Yep. Thanks to tidal friction, the moon is gradually stealing Earth's rotational energy. As a result, the moon drifts away by about 3.8 centimeters per year, and Earth's days get longer by about 1.7 milliseconds per century. Wild, right? And some geophysicists speculate that this constant off-center mass distribution might subtly influence Earth's liquid outer core motion, possibly affecting our magnetic field or even tectonic rhythms over vast timescales. No, it's not the moon causing earthquakes directly, but the Earth-Moon gravitational dance adds a layer of rhythmic pressure to an already restless planet. So in short, that little barycenter isn't just some nerdy footnote in an astronomy textbook. It's part of a living, moving system that shapes our days, tides, satellites, calendars, even our ability to detect alien life. And all of it because the Earth isn't quite the center of its own story. Thanks for watching.